Children, welcome back to English class. In today's session, we'll be doing English 1. Okay, lesson 7, unit is strength. This is your last chapter of lesson 7 of the English 1. Okay, lesson 7, unit is strength. All of you kindly open your textbook, page number 39. Okay, I'll read the lesson, kindly follow.
Once upon a time, four birds lived in a meadow. There was plenty of grass for them. They used to feed on fresh grass and live happily. Most of the animals who lived nearby were afraid of them. No one dared to fight with them as they always kept together. A lion lived in a forest nearby. He tried to attack them several times. But the birds kept together and helped each other to drive him off.
So what happened? Once upon a time, in a forest, that is in a meadow. Meadow is nothing but a grassy land. Okay? From the railway carriage, you all have done the poem, no? Read the poem from the railway carriage. In that meadows, when you travel through the train, you can see meadows. Meadows is what? Grassy field. Okay? What is meadow? Meadow is a grassy field. Okay? So, grasses, you know, cow eats only veg, it eats only grass, right? So, bulls, these are four bulls, they are friends, okay? These four bulls are the friends. And see, this is a meadow, it's a grassy field, okay? So, the crows are eating grass in the grassy field. There was plenty of grass for them, okay? There's so much grass. You can see here, there's so much of grass, right? There's so much of grass. So what they used to do, all these four bulls, they are friends. They used to eat the fresh grass and they used to stay happily. And what happened, most of the animals, whatever the animals were there nearby, they were all afraid of these bulls. And they never thought of fighting with them, okay? Because they always stayed together. If someone used to come and fight with them, all four used to attack the other animal and other animals were scared of them because of that. Okay? But in the forest, there was one lion. And you know, lion eat cows, deer, all then what else? It eats goat, sheep, cattle. It eats all the cattle, right? So, a lion, he always tried to attack these bulls. But since all the four bulls were staying together, they used to drive the lion off. They also used to attack the lion. All four lion, four bulls attacking one lion. Okay, they also used to attack the lion together, and the lion used to run off. Okay, since all the bulls were together and they were helping each other when any of the one was in trouble, no one thought of attacking them. All were afraid of them.
The lion had little hope of eating them because he was no match for four strong bulls with their sharp horns and hooves. But he could not keep away from the meadow, for it is hard to resist watching a good meal, even when there is little chance of getting it. Those four are always together. How to separate them? Wondered the lion. Soon he came up with a plan.
So what happened, children, whatever I've underlined, kindly underline the same. You also underline the same, okay? Okay, so what happened? The lion always tried to attack them, but he was always lost, okay? The all four bulls, they used to drive him off, okay? So the lion had no hopes of, you know, that one fine day he'll eat the bull, enjoy eating the bull and all. He doesn't have hopes. But despite of that, he still, you know, wanted, that craving was there, that he wants to eat them, that was there, okay? But whenever he looks at the bulls, their sharp horns, as you see, you know, the long horns, okay? A kombu, in Kannada they call kombu, no? Those are the horns, the long horns and hooves. Hooves are nothing but the foot of the cow or bull, okay? It will be like this U-shape, right? It will be inverted U-shape. Okay, that is called as the hooves, the foot of the bull, hooves, okay? Hooves is nothing but the foot of the bull or horses or anything, okay? So, he always used to see that their foot, the hooves and the horns were very sharp, and he was always scared of them. But still, he couldn't stay away from them. Because they were so big and hefty, healthy. He wanted to eat them very badly. All these bulls looked very, very tasty for him. Okay, and he could not resist. Resist is nothing but control. He couldn't control himself. Okay, so what did he think? Those four are always together. How to separate them? Pondered the lion. Pondered is nothing but thought. Okay, thinking. Thought the lion. Pondered. Pondered is nothing but thought. Okay. Pondered is nothing but thought the lion.
He kept a close watch over the bulls. As soon as one of them moved slightly away while grazing, he came up close to him and said, "Hello friend, how nice to see you." Turn your page, children. The bull was startled but not too alarmed, since three of his friends were close by, and if the lion tried to attack, he was confident that the four of them would easily overpower him. So, in order to be polite, the bull replied, "Hello. The other bulls get more grass than you," said the lion. "This is not right." Saying these words, the lion went away. The lion went around and said the same words to each of the four bulls. He was very happy with the trick he had played. "Now, I think their unity will not last long. They will soon quarrel with one another, and I will be able to kill them one by one," thought the lion. Everything happened just as the lion had thought. Each bull thought that the others got more grass than he himself. They did not trust each other, so they no longer kept together and each went on his own way.
So what happened? These bulls, they were looking very, very yummy and tasty for the lion. He couldn't stay away from them at all. So he thought of a plan. What did he do? He said, "Okay, now I'll do one thing. I'll go to first. I'll make sure I separate these bulls. If these four bulls are together, and if I attack anyone, then I won't be able to." Eat them. Okay, they will overpower me. Overpower is nothing but they'll become more strong and he'll become less. Okay, power is strength. Okay, overpower is more strong. They will make him lose. Okay, they will defeat. Overpower is nothing but defeating. Okay, so he said, if all four are together, then if I attack anyone, I will be defeated. So instead of that, I have to separate them. I have to first separate all these four bulls, and then one by one I have to attack. Okay, so he thinks about that and he will have a plan in his mind. So now he'll keep observing these bulls for some time. Okay, then when he sees that one bull is little away from the other three bulls, then he'll go to the bull slowly, he'll sneak in and he'll say, "Hello bull, how are you?" And he'll just try to be friendly. The bull gets startled, okay, the bull is also afraid, the bull is a little bit afraid of this. But still, the bull will see that his friends are close by. So he's like, "Yeah, okay, hello, how are you, what do you want from me?" So now the lion will say, "See, you are such a good bull, but your friends, you know, you always get little grass, and your friends, they always get more grass than you. They only eat more and they make sure that you eat only little grass. So sad of you, you know, I don't know why your friends do like this to you." He'll start talking wrong about his friends. So the bull is quite foolish enough, the bull is not smart that he's not able to know that the lion is trying to trick him. Okay, so the bull will also feel, "Oh really, yes, I always eat less grass and my friends are eating more fresh grass. So bad of them, I don't know why they are doing this. Okay, from now onwards, I won't be their friends." Okay, the bull will also decide not to be friends with them again. And The lion is happy now. Okay, my trick is working. So what will the lion do? One by one, the lion will keep observing each one of the bull. And when one of the bull is quite away from the other three bulls, it will go and say the same words to all the four bulls. Okay, it will go tell all the bulls the same thing. Okay, it will go to the second bull also and will say, I don't know why all your friends, you know, they eat more nice fresh grass, and for you always they make sure you eat only little grass and some old dried grasses. They don't you know, let you eat all the fresh one, and more grass wherever is there, they all eat. You then always make sure they give you less. So he says the same to all the four bulls separately. Okay, the bulls are so foolish enough that they don't go and discuss with each other that, see, lion has told like this, why are you doing it? They don't go and talk properly. Okay, they keep it to themselves and they think, yes, my friends are cheating me. And all these four bulls stop talking to each other. Okay, and now they are not friends anymore. And the lion is so happy because of this, because he's observing from far, no? The lion is happy. He's like, very good, my trick is working. Now, these four bulls, they will soon quarrel with each other. Quarrel is nothing but fight, okay? They will soon fight with each other and they won't come and help the other bull if I kill them also. They won't come and help them. Now, they don't talk to each other. They don't like each other also. So, it's good. My trick has worked. Now, I can eat any bull I want when the right time comes. Okay, and they won't even help each other, nor they don't even trust each other. Okay.
This was what the lion had wished for. One day he got the chance and sprang upon one of the bulls and ate him. The other bulls did not come to his help. Next week, the lion pounced on another bull and ate him. Again, the other bulls did not come to help their friend. After a few days, the lion again visited the field. As soon as he got the chance, he jumped upon the third bull and ate him too. Now, only one bull was left. I'll eat all the grass alone. I did not share it with anyone, laughed the bull. But his happiness did not last long. One day, when he was grazing in the field, the lion came and sprang upon the last bull. He tore him to pieces and ate him. All the bulls died one by one because they were no longer united. It is very well said, united we stand and divided we fall.
Okay, so what happened? Just like the lion wanted, just like the lion thought, okay, one day the lion goes and attacks one of the bull. He kills him, sprang upon us, jumping. If you have all seen the National Geographic Channel and all, or Discovery Channel, the show how the lions attack, no? They go and jump on him, that is sprang, okay? The jumping, sudden jump is called as sprang. The lion sprang upon one of the bull and he eats the bull. Okay, but the other three bulls, they don't come for help because they're no longer their friends and they no longer talk to each other. So they don't come for help. Okay, then after that, next week, this week the lion won't come attack. He won't come to the meadow to attack. So these cows, these bulls are grazing easily. Grazing is nothing but they eating, roaming around and eating the grass. That is called as grazing. Okay, roaming around and eating the grass in the field, in the meadow, is called as grazing. Okay, so now the cow, bulls are grazing normally, and again after 1 week the lion will come to the meadow and he'll attack the second bull. Again the second bull will also die and the other two bulls won't come for help. The lion is enjoying eating the bull now. Okay, then after that, again after few more days, the lion will come to the meadow, eat the third bull also. Okay, when the lion attacks each of the bull, the other bulls will think, okay, now he is dead, so I have more grass to eat, they keep thinking that. They are so foolish that they can't even think that we are being killed, we are being tricked and we are being killed. Okay, one by one, even we'll all die very soon. They don't think that. They think that, okay, that bull is dead, let him die, it's okay. I'll have so much grass to eat. They'll be thinking like that as a fool. Okay. Now again, after some days, the lion will come, attack to the meadow, he'll attack the third bull and three bulls are killed. The last bull will feel so happy. He'll say, ah, all the bulls are dead now. I have so much grass to eat. I can easily eat all this grass and live happily. But the bull won't even think that he is the next one to be attacked. The lion will come and attack him and kill him also. Okay, same way the lion comes, he sprang upon him and tear him into pieces and he kills and eats the fourth bull also. Okay, now all the four bulls are dead. Why are they dead? Because they are foolish enough that they couldn't know that what the lion is trying to do. Correct? No, they don't even know that they are being divided and they are being killed. When they were all these four bulls were together, was the lion able to kill them? No, they were very strong enough. But as soon as they got divided, the lion killed them one by one. So it clearly shows that when we are united, nobody can overpower us, nobody can defeat us. But when we are single, that is when people can easily divide us. If you all know, okay, if you take the broomstick, okay, there is one stick. If you take one stick, you can break easily. Two stick also it's okay. 3, 4, 5. When it starts increasing and you have a bunch of sticks, try to break it with your bare hands. Can you break it? No, it's very difficult because it is strong enough now. Okay, when it is single, you can easily break it with your fingers like this. But when it is more, when you have a bunch of it, if you hold together with only 5 hands also, it's quite difficult, right? You need more and more strength. It's not that easy. So that clearly shows when you are single, you can easily be defeated. But when you're together, okay, when you are united, you can't be defeated. So that is what the saying is about. United we stand and divided we fall. United we are very strong and defeat, and we are not, we cannot be defeated. But when we are not united, when we are divided among each other, then we can be easily defeated, we can be fallen. Okay, understood? So this is a nice story, children. Hope you all understood. Please read the chapter. If you have any doubts, kindly ask me in the interactive session. Okay, thank you.